Hey Jackalls, in my last videos I've done comparison between GPU and CPU rendering times in DaVinci Resolve 17, and I've done that at maximum performance. While I can't use my GPU to do additional tests, I can use my CPU. Because this test can only be done by scaling down the number of cores, so from 6 to 4 and 2, I can test what the performance would be like if I had more than 6 cores. So when I do have a better CPU, I may do this video again. Now if you don't have the time to watch all the way till the end, the short answer is you need 4 cores. But if you want to know how I came to that conclusion, the tests that I've done, and how I've done them, then continue watching. Now let's get digital.
So this is how I'll do the test. As you can see, the CPU speed is at 4 GHz, and what I'll be doing is I'll disable the cores. So in this MSI BIOS, this is done under the OC, down control, as you can see it's set to auto, and I have a 2 core and a 4 core option, and the auto one is 6 core. So to start off, I'll just use 2 cores. And sometimes it happens that the left monitor gets the signal. So let's see if this saved. No, it didn't. So I guess I have to save this. Save and exit. As you can see, this will now be a 1+1. And as you can see, we have 2 cores. So I'll just launch DaVinci Resolve. And as you can see, we only have 4 cores. What I want to do is to see if disabling Affinity or the logical cores in the BIOS gives the same result. So this will be the test file, and I can go to performance and look at the CPU.
So this will be the project that I'll be using. I'll be giving each one a different name. As for the settings, I'll have MP4, codec H.264, the encoder will be set to native, which means the CPU, and under the advanced settings, I'll use full data levels, and I'll enable use rendered cache images.
So this will be CPU to BIOS, select the CPU, render this out, advanced settings, full, and use rendered cache, rendered queue. And let's see how long this will take. So this one is almost done. Let's see the result. So the result is this. It's 10 seconds slower than before. And I guess that means that these processors also had to do other tasks that the PC needed, which by disabling Affinity means that the disabled cores would actually be able to do those tasks instead of the ones that were specified to just use DaVinci Resolve. So I'll do this test again. This time I'll use only 4 cores. As you can see, we have 2 cores and 4 threads. This time it's going to be 2+2. And I just need to save this. Save and exit. Yes. And we'll see how fast this will be. This time we have 4 cores and 8 threads. Again, the only thing that's running is the task manager, keypass, NVIDIA control panel, UMC, and MSI. So let's do the same project. As you can see, we now have 8 threads from 0 to 7. Previously, by setting the affinity, this was done anywhere from 1 minute and 16 to 1 minute and 24. And this time we have 1 minute and 29. So I'll do the test again, now with the fully unlocked CPU, because the test that I did previously was also running all sorts of apps, and this time I'm not using any of them. Okay, I'm in. Let's see the CPU. As you can see, we have 6 cores and 12 threads. Let's open the DaVinci Resolve, and the result is, this time, 1 minute and 8 seconds. So it was basically the same as before. So this was the proper way of testing it, by going into the BIOS, but what you can also do is open the task manager, Control Shift Escape is the shortcut, go to details, find any other app that you want to apply this to, right click on it, and choose set affinity. This will specify the number of threads that the process will use. So as you can see, all of the CPU cores are selected, and this means also the threads, and basically CPU 0 and CPU 1 is core 1, and so on until you get to CPU 10 and 11, which is core 6. In this case, the processor has 6 cores. So now if I disable 4 of them, this means that the CPU only has 4 cores to work with. So let's do that test, and all of the settings will be the same. And now what we want to get is result similar to this one, 129. But in this case, I expect the result to be a little bit faster, because all of the disabled cores can do other tasks while this is running. So let's take a look. If I go to performance and open the resource monitors, so the last 4 CPUs, as you can see, actually do some tasks. So I disabled the last 4 cores, but as you can see, they still do something. But if you disable the cores in the BIOS, then these cores don't do anything. And that's why the rendering was actually slower, because these cores actually had to do these tasks as well. And we have, as you can see, 116, which is a lot faster than 129. And now I'll do the same thing again, only this time I'll disable another 4 threads. 1, 2, 3, 4. So now only 2 cores will do all of the work. So let's do this last test. So the result is now in, and as you can see, the result is basically the same as it was before. 2 minute 27, and this one is 2 minute 28, and this one is 2 minute 27. Based on these results, how many cores should the CPU have? Well, let's take a look. At least 4 cores should be good enough, because this result is almost twice as fast as this one, and having anything more than 4, in this case I only have 6, so I can't test anything beyond that, so having 6 cores doesn't give that much of a better result. Thank you.